King of Kowloon is really one of the most important figures in all of visual culture in Hong Kong's recent history. He is a unique and special individual who brought part of Hong Kong's soul together for a good 30, 40 years that he was drawing and writing calligraphy in the streets. As everybody knows, his story is a claim that his family owned, his ancestors owned the land of Kowloon. It was stolen by the British without compensation and never really kind of made whole. And so he went to the streets proclaiming, in a very ancient way actually, a type of protest and claim to this territory by writing publicly in the streets in calligraphy. Now, he was a known nuisance. He was arrested many times. He was shooed away and often had kind of conflicts with the business owners on whom walls he was writing. But at the same time, he created an experience, a visual experience for the people of Hong Kong for four decades, and he became part of the collective memory of Hong Kong. He's incredibly valuable when we think about Hong Kong's place, not only in the art world, but really as a society and as a major metropolis and our own cultural contributions to the world. Now, I think that the King of Kowloon has been lost for many years, lost to the public's attention. And it's great that with Google, we're able to reach so many people so easily in such an accessible way at, you know, really the tip of their fingers online. So what we're seeing here is number two on the list of last remaining King of Kowloon works in the wild. Now, out of all the six works that I know of that have been documented by Google Cultural Institute and the King of Kowloon Project with Art Research Institute, what we're really seeing here is a protected box. Now, at some point, the King of Kowloon raised enough attention from the kind of local community where they demanded that his work be protected, that his work be preserved for future generations. In response, the Hong Kong government gave us this. It is a plastic box which is open at the top to allow airflow. But even if we're not able to protect so many of the last remaining physical works, what we can do is migrate the attention and migrate the viewing and experience of the King of Kowloon online, so there will be no weather to destroy it, no paint to paint over it. And what hopefully we'll still be able to experience the King of Kowloon's work and his significance for 50, 100, 200, 300 years down the line.
The Google Cultural Institute is really about making sure that the best of the world's artworks, historic moments and world wonders are accessible to people all the way around the world. So we bring technology and our partners bring the ability to collect and to curate the items that you see in the Cultural Institute. And what it means is that no matter where you are around the world, you can access the collection. And we now have over 6 million items in the Cultural Institute at any time. As long as you have an internet connection, they're just one click away. So if you have a look at the website, the Google Cultural Institute website, what you'll see is a hub that contains over 6 million items. They're divided into three key areas. So we have works of art, we have a collection around historic moments, such as D-Day, for example, and we have access to key world wonders, such as the Taj Mahal or the temples of Angkor Wat or Stonehenge. For a site that has so many items in it, I think you'll find it's very, very easy to find what you're interested in, and it's very, very easy to kind of scroll through those items as well. In the World Wonder section in particular, we've used technologies such as 3D technology to really bring those spaces to life. So with the temples of Angkor Wat or Taj Mahal, you can really immerse yourself in those environments and have a very powerful experience that really brings you into those places. We've also seen in the works of art section that we can use technology such as gigapixel technology to really allow you to zoom right into the work of art and to have an experience that you can't have in the real world. In terms of Tsang Tsou Choi and the King of Kowloon, that was our latest project. We've taken a small selection of his incredible life's output. He actually was working here in Hong Kong for over 50 years and produced 55,000 pieces of art in and around Hong Kong. We've taken 170 of those and we've brought them to the Cultural Institute. We've also been able to tell his life story. And we know he's an incredible cultural icon for people here in Hong Kong. So it's fantastic to be able to collect and to share his work for people in Hong Kong, but also for people around the world. Because he was a street artist, his work is naturally transient and ephemeral. So by bringing it into the Cultural Institute now, we can preserve it for future generations, and that's incredibly powerful. And we hope that all of those projects in the Google Cultural Institute, working with our partners here in Hong Kong, will really add something to the vibrancy and the creativity of the scene here in Hong Kong.
Amazing. Right now we're at a Choi Hong temple, a very traditional Chinese temple. And what we're seeing here is really some of the hidden language, the secret underlying language of the King of Kowloon. I love this lamp, this lantern. Visually, if you look at 80% of the King of Kowloon's works, you'll find these characters emphasized over all else. And so it's interesting to see the relationship between the King of Kowloon and this neighborhood where he used to live, and also the types of influences that he took from all around him, taking them from the streets essentially, processing them, and putting them back on the streets. By and large, art is always best experienced in person. There's no way you can recreate or replace the experience of standing in front of a painting and just feeling its power. Artists and their practice are typically problem solvers. Now, when you get to the digital realm, it's really just another problem to solve. How to express one's ideas using the materials, tools, or technology at hand.